just go back about 100 years or 200 years or 300 years, how people lived. They lived very happily. There was not much of environment pollution. And the convenience were not much, and the limited life, they were happy. Now, we have standard of living has improved, we have all the facilities, but what happened? The environment hazards are there, you don't have good water, you don't have good air, so everything is being polluted. If this situation continues, what will be in 2050? I have just compared 1,000 years and 50 years only. In another 50 years, the whole land of India will become a heap of waste only. That is the current situation. So it is time for, let us think about these things. All these things because our technology, no? Man thinks about himself only. There are 84 lakhs living beings in the world. Only one is a human being. 83,99,999 living beings are not taken care of. And he only develops so many products, cosmetics, drugs, fertilizer, biodiesel, paper, so on. All these industries have given residues to the world only and creates problem. So all these things give more problem. That is more because of the philosophy. The industrial philosophy, you know, produce, market, forget. They never bother about, once you give it, once you give it goes to the market, then public uses, they never bother about it. Similarly, the domestic people, they consume, use and throw, forget it. The municipality, collect it, forget it. All the, what happens to all the waste materials getting collected only. There is a definitely response, so own yourself. There is a response for everyone. The industry, the organization, individuals are very important. I just mentioned a paste tube here, I mentioned for example only. Every day we use paste. We don't know why we use that particular paste. And we simply throw away, split away the waste. And this goes to the ground. It pollutes the water. And the tube, Per year, we collect about 2 lakh tons of tubes alone. And where it goes, how you are going to solve this problem. So think about it. And similarly, plastic waste. Now we are talking about smart cities. Urban people creating confusion in the society. Your gas is polluting atmosphere by producing carbon dioxide. What we need is 50% of the gas only because of inefficient cooker structure, inefficient burner. We consume, we convert it more, we use more. And then similarly, our fuel, water, tire, e-waste, going on adding more and more materials for your convenience and ultimately creating problem to the society. We need to solve the problem. Smart cities doesn't mean advanced cities. Smart cities means convenient cities. Let us try to have convenient for the public in every aspect. And so that is possible only. Fortunately, our government is very positive, and Swachh Bharat is a very, very positive mantra and a great movement, and it includes all the three, industry, institution, and social environment. And I just want to say something about the ownership here. Industry can produce the product, but they should be eco-friendly. Or if they produce anything, they must try to collect back the waste materials. So, for example, toothpaste is supplied to the market. After the use, if they return that tube alone, they can reduce 5% of the cost. Thereby, they can collect the manufacturer, collect back it, and then accumulate one place, and then he thinks back about the reuse of the material scientifically, or he can organize using some institution to do that, which is not being done by any other industry. They produce, market it, forget it. No industry takes back the waste material, whether it's plastic industry or any other material. This is one of the very important aspects that's why I want to stress upon that. You have a responsibility to take back material and recycle it or reuse it and give a better atmosphere to the people concerned. And in our domestic people, we use and throw it only. There is a poor garbage culture. Our plastic is not properly segregated and used, and water is, they had a lecture there, water is wasted, grey water is enormous water. And now, I can going on talking about that, we have the time restriction, no? For water, you know, if you use, how many cleaning agents are being used? All those cleaning agents are polluting the water and polluting the atmosphere. We are, every day we are increasing the pollutant in the water by all our modern materials. So, it is very important These three institutions, society, industry, and government should join together to develop appropriate technology. And I call it innovation, not innovation. It is Indian way of innovation is very important. What is suitable for us is very important. What is needed for me is very important. For India has got 75% of the village people. They need more facility. We need to supply for them. How to reuse is very important. So I have done some work on the plastic waste, and e-waste, rubber waste, oil waste, organic waste, wastewater, fuels, solid waste. Some of these things we have taken into consideration, and we did a lot of work in this direction. And for plastic, films, cups, foams, actually carry bags, teacups, thermocool, biscuit covers, kurkure covers, all these covers, chocolate covers, panpura covers, all these things cannot be recycled. It can be reused. We have developed a new technique called road laying for that. All our plastic can be used. And India doesn't have enough plastic to lay all the Indian roads. So, therefore, similarly, e-waste is being used to convert it into a polymer modified bitumen. And from seaweed, we have developed a new component which is very useful for curing diabetes wounds. And organic waste manure, waste can be converted to manure in 15 days. We have developed a technique like that. And rubber modified bitumen. So slag, debris, concrete debris, limestone, like that, many solid waste are available. All those things are now converted into useful product in our laboratory. And to add something about my simple work on plastic, use waste plastic I use, and we get a better road. We lay the road in 2002. Starting from 2002, we are laying the road. We lay the road 2002 in Chennai. Even today, the road is functioning well without a pothole or a crack. 14 years. One person is not appreciating this. That is a contractor. Because he is not favoring this because every year he wants to lay the road. But India, only 10% of the road has been blackened. 90% are yet to be converted into blacktop. They can as well go and lay the road, no problem. India has got 41 lakh kilometers of road. So the better road and the cost saving, we are saving 10% of bitumen. We are using, if I lay 1 kilometer road, plastic road, normally we require 10 tons of bitumen. Now I use only 9 tons of bitumen and 1 ton of plastic. And I will explain how it is so. 1 ton of plastic means 10 lakhs carry bags. In 1 kilometer, I use 10 lakh carry bags. Means, imagine, if you go around Bombay, you may not get even 2 or 3 tons of plastic, and it just is sufficient to go lay 2 kilometers or 3 kilometers road. But such is the consumption of plastic here. And cost-wise less. The technology is so simple. And solid waste, organic, automatically becomes manure. And it gives a job in Tamil Nadu. Every district has got a sulfur group, and now they sell plastic, shredded plastic, per kilo 30 rupees, value addition taking place. And the technique is very simple, very, very simple. Normally, I used to introduce myself only by, a waste becomes useful because of another waste. The first waste is myself, and the plastic is another waste. That waste has made me to stand before you. And here, the aggregate is taken. Road laying is very simple technique. Take the stone, heat it to 170 degree, add bitumen, mix it, lay the road, finish. If they do this correctly, 170 and 160, the road will last strong for minimum 3 years, if even this road, without any pothole. But they don't do, that is that you know about it. What I am doing is, take the same stone, heat it to 170 degree. Take this plastic, your carry bags, thermocool, all those things. I don't want to segregate it, mix together. I want only dry material. Even if it is containing some impurities, don't bother. Cut it into small pieces. And some samples are kept here. Pieces which is 2 mm to 4 mm, you cut it and spray it over the stone. You just spray at the hot stone, you spray this plastic waste. And within 10 minutes, the stone is coated. And the stone is laminated. Once it's laminated, add the bitumen, mix it, lay the road. The plastic has a beautiful binder between the stone and the bitumen. And the strength of the road is doubled.
Normally requirement 1000 kg only. Now this road will stand 2500 kg. So to modern transportation, volume of transport, this is the best road available. And no pothole is being formed in the road, because normally why pothole is formed is between when water is stagnated, between the water penetrates between stone and the bitumen and peeling off taking place. Now what happens is we are coating plastic over that and bitumen is added. The plastic has a beautiful binder between these two and water never penetrates. The road which he laid in 2002, 2003, till today, there is not even a single pothole formed. So the roads are definitely performing very well. So take the aggregate, heat it to 170 degree, waste plastic, spread over that calculated quantity. The ratio is 1:10. So as I told you, if you need 10 tons of bitumen, use 9 tons, 1 ton of plastic. And thereby you save the cost. Bitumen is saved. The cost of bitumen is 50,000 rupees. Plastic is only waste. So cost waste. And then maintenance. Every year India is spending 3,000 crores of rupees have been for maintenance. Here for 10 years, no maintenance required. And mix this, lay it, forget it. So this road is simply very good. And see, this is a technology where it is being shedded and then coated and then added and then the road is laid. And see the road. The road on one side is a road which has been laid by the government. The other road which you see is a plastic road. This road was laid in 2004. You can come and see the road in Madurai. Even today, the road is functioning the same way, the same surface, it is maintained only. So nothing happens. So road is beautiful. And and as I told you, India has got 41 lakhs kilometers, of which 24 lakhs kilometers rural roads. Let us try to convert the rural roads into plastic road, because it is laid once in 10 years only. And if you convert it, all your transportation from the village to cities will become very easy, economic condition improved. And you know, India has got only 3 lakhs tons of plastic. And what I need is 1 lakh ton, 1 ton per kilometer. India has got 41 lakhs kilometers. Now, how much of plastic required is 100 lakhs tons of plastic is required. What is available is only 30 lakhs only. So we need excess plastic which is to be imported from other countries, or use more plastic and give it to me. Let us lay a plastic road and be happy. Let us live happily in this world. So all the roads are, so see here, the strength is improved, no potholes is formed, withstand heavy load, decreased bitumen consumed, value addition to the plastic, no effect here, and multi-layer can be used, no machinery is required, simple technique, already existing, no industry involvement, in-situ process, and I have developed a new technique called scrap method, already laid road, scrap the top layer alone, and collect it, and coat it, and lay it. Collect nothing else. You need not get any new material. The same, the cost wise 50% reduced. And the road is again 10 years old. This we have laid at near Chennai, and this has been appreciated by the chief engineers of India. So this process is wonderful. Now what they are asking me is, normally they used to have a 40 centimeter thickness of 40 mm thickness of a road. They say, oh, you want to have 40, let us have a 20, because your road is strong. So in that manner also the cost wise is going to be reduced, the natural material is going to be reduced, so value addition has been given, and so bitumen cost reduced, aggregate saved, cost reduced, disposal scrap becomes easy. Now this is another product which has been developed in the process. This is called, this is about plastone. This is another product which has been developed. This is made up of stone and plastic alone, nothing else. Only stone and plastic, and these two made into a block. And this is what is called synthetic granite or plastone. This can withstand 300 tons load without any break, where concrete load can act only 60, whereas 300 tons load. And even if you apply load, it never breaks, it extends. A structural material which has got extend such elastic property, in the world, this is the first material of its kind. There is no such material available. And nearly about 10 countries are asking this method for them. I have not yet given. Even my plastic technology, one company from States offered me $300 million to take the technology to them. I said, I'm not giving. I'm giving to my country only, freely. And we are maintaining that also. So this, the additional characteristic of this plastone is, here I use not only plastic and stone, the solid waste. Either it can be granite, or it can be concrete debris, or it can be ceramic debris, or it can be limestone debris. I know one of the company in Bombay produces 1,000 tons of limestone waste, which is dumped in the sea. We can very well convert them into useful product. We are taking product, and I am the consultant of the company also, and we are now developing wonderful product, structural material. This can be used for pathway blocking, walking on both sides, roadside blocking. It can be used water lining, canal lining, launches can be laid. This can have enormous varieties of purposes, and people say this got resistance toward bullet, it has resistance towards earthquake. So once this product made up of two wastes, made by one more waste, waste plastic and waste stone by waste man. So this has been made wonderful product, and this helps so well, and therefore is a wonderful product. If this comes out into market, I just given one statistical value. India has got 60,000 kilometers of highways. If the both sides of the highways, if you lay a pathway block using this stone, I need 30 lakh tons of plastic. India has got only 3 lakh tons of plastic. So that means, the World Bank authority, he heard about it. He jumped with joy. You have solved the problems of plastic, he said. So that is how this is. We have to import waste plastic, nothing else. And we can, in this block, I can use bottles. I can use e-waste. So the problem is being, next big problem is e-waste. That's also coming now. So the need of the hour is, ownership is very important. Everybody has got a ownership. I'm happy TEDx has got fields of ownership. That's why this arrangement has been made. I am very, very happy to say that. And everyone has got the social responsibility. We got just like throw anything outside. And then life is sharing and caring. Remember that. It is sharing and caring. I care. I need to care my others' life also. I must share my happiness to others also. Therefore, very, very important. Above all, health is more important. So we create an environmental, very poor environment, toxic environment. If this continues, we'll have very bad. And we are giving to our next generation a very bad atmosphere. Take care about it. Therefore, let us be smart person, create smart person, smart organization, and finally, smart India. This is, let us start from smart person, not from smart cities. I wish you all the best. I hope you will join with me in this movement. Thank you very much.